Hello students, welcome to the Cambridge assessment class. I am Ruhi and I'll be telling you in detail what is Cambridge assessments. So there are many students who are confused regarding Cambridge assessment. What is YLE? What is Cambridge assessment? What is CAE advanced? What is C1 advanced? So today all your doubts will be cleared in this video. So I have come on this website. It is www.cambridgeenglish.org. So you can visit that website, and under that you can come in C1 advanced section. I've already logged in over here. So over here we come to know. So all the updates are given in this official website, students. This is the official website from the Cambridge University. It is called the Cambridge Assessment English. Okay, so now over here we come to know that the name of Cambridge CAE that I had told you, Certificate in Advanced English, the name has changed from CAE to C1 Advanced. So now we will be calling CAE as C1 Advanced. So what is it? What it is? Why we should have this examination? How the certificate is helpful to us in many other ways that we'll be learning in detail from the official website of Cambridge University. So we'll go over here. So more than 9,000 educational institutions, business and government department around the world accept C1 advanced as a proof of high level achievement in English. It means that if you have the certificate and you show this certificate in when you have to go for higher education in any part of the world, if you have to achieve a job, they will hire you or give you the first preference, because C1 advanced certificate is the proof of high level achievement in English. Okay, so we are now, what is it? So it's preparing for C1. It helps the learners to develop skills to make most of studying, working and living in English speaking countries. So what is the main idea behind C1 Advanced is that if you want to study in a English speaking country, if you want to do a job in English speaking country, so you can show the certificate and you are very well accepted to have a job over there, to study over there. Okay, so it is a proof that you are very good in speaking English. So this exam is a journey between B2 first and C2 proficiency. So before C1 advanced, there is a level B2 first, and then there is a level C2 advanced. I'm so sorry. Okay. So key facts are given. We'll just jump on number of papers. There are 4 number of papers and the exam length is 4 hours. Okay. So we'll come reasons to choose C1 Advanced. So monthly tests are available. 9,000 educational institute and business and government departments accept this, and you have open doors to travel international, work, international travel, work and study. So there is no limitation, there is no boundary for y'all if you have C1 Advanced certificate. Okay. So now we just jump here, students. There is a YouTube channel also. I had shared the link of it last year itself with all the students through Prisms to subscribe the channel, because in that channel they give updates of how to have speaking test, how to do listening test, how to face the interviewer with the examiner and the interlocutor. It is the official website of the channel. So now we'll just jump onto the most important thing over here. Now we'll just come over here down. to understand who accepts C1 advance. This is the most important thing. So there are few of the leading organizations they are given, and there are many more organizations that accept it. So it's Oxford University, University of Sydney, Stanford University, Dell, Nestle, Deloitte, and all these universities and these organizations accept this certificate. Okay, now we'll just jump on to exam format. What is the exam format? Because most of the students are very much confused, or they don't understand, or they are very scared of Cambridge assessments. That we'll understand. Okay, so the first thing, the video that I had made earlier was on reading and use of English. So you can see the paper, reading and use of English. You can see over here the contents are 8 parts are there in that, and total are 56 questions. And this shows that you have to deal confidently with text. What type of text can come? It can come from newspapers, magazines. It will test your English. It will have exercises, and it will also test your grammar and vocabulary. The second paper is the writing part, which has 2 parts again. It has essays, letters, emails, proposals, reports, and reviews. We have listening parts. Students, through videos only I'll be teaching you about listening parts. That video will come later on, I promise you. Listening has 4 parts total. In all, they have 30 questions. It tests your ability to understand the spoken material, such as radios, interview, broadcasts, and everyday things from all walks of life. It can be a normal conversation also. And then we have speaking. 15 minutes per pair is given, and there is an examiner and an interlocutor. So if you go for a speaking test for Cambridge assessments, the people from Cambridge University come, and there is one examiner who is actually examining you. And she's asking you questions, and behind her there is an interlocutor who takes note, who is not in direct conversation with you, but she or he is the person who takes note of everything that you are saying, and her observation and her or his record taking is very much involved in giving you marks. So she is basically an observer, and the interviewer is the person who is taking your interview is the interviewer. So this actually tests your ability to communicate effectively and in face-to-face situations, and how you speak. Okay, so basically this whole thing is here in detail, it is given. So time for reading and use of English paper is 1 hour 30 minutes. I've explained you all these things. And you can go down and search that what is in part 1, what you have to practice. You can just get down and search and read it for yourself. Okay, students. So each and every explanation is given for each and every part. Everything is crystal clear with Cambridge assessments. Nothing is hidden, or nothing is, hidden from you, that no, this was not told and this thing came into the question paper. Nothing is like that. It all depends on your preparation. So we go back and, okay, so over here I had, yes, read about our new exam names. So students, every year or whenever they feel like, they change the name of the exam. So that is not a big deal, but I'll go there and show you for your clarification. So students, one thing I should make it very clear, that YLE is not what you are studying right now. YLE is called for, the name YLE is actually the old name. So you can see over here the old name, and YLE movers, YLE starters, YLE flyers. So their new names have been changed, as you can see over here. So YLE is for the very, very basic level, you know, where they start from ABCD, they do picture reading and all these things. So those are, that subjects are called YLE. But as your level starts to increase from KET, PET, FCE, CAE and CPE, that is no longer called students from A to flyers level, sorry, from KET level, A to key for schools, till C to proficiency, y'all are not called YLE. Y'all are called Cambridge Assessment, or the name that is provided by the Cambridge Assessment Organization. So as I told you, your earlier name over here you can see is CAE, but the name has been changed from 2017 to C1 Advanced. So this will not be called as YLE, this will not be called as CAE, this will be called C1 Advanced. I hope this is clear to you. Over here also, this Cambridge English Qualification, General and Higher Education. So students, you all are on the second last level. The last level is a much more higher level, which is called as C2 Proficiency. Okay, students. So I hope, students, many things are clear to you and you don't face any doubt. If at all you have any doubt, feel free to email me the details. I'll get back to you. Stay safe, stay indoors, and wash your hands regularly. Thank you, students.